Diana! You dear sweet thing! Good evening!
Hello, Mrs. Packard. Hello, Enid on top. I'm early because I got changed at the club and came straight up from town. Canteen work all day. How is everyone?
I've been working at the hospital all afternoon.
Oh, isn't Enid a trump doing the home nursing and letting someone else get the glory over there? Of course I've gone over there myself,
you know. Why didn't you?
Oh, I don't know, but I love the romance of being there. Enid, why don't you fetch that letter that your brother wrote and show it to Mrs. Packard? He writes such unusually interesting descriptions.
Yes, it's most interesting. I won't be a moment. It's in my desk upstairs.
Oh, my dear Miss Chesborough, pardon me for seeming to presume, but I am only trying to save you. Are you aware of what people are saying about you?
Saying about me?
Of course, they wouldn't say it to you.
What wouldn't they say?
It's so much easier to flatter than to say disagreeable things.
People are saying disagreeable things about me.
You haven't heard?
No, but I should certainly like to know.
Of course you would. Any young girl like you. But, my dear, do you really think you should come to this house?
Come to this house? But why not? Enid and I went to school together. She is one of my best and oldest friends.
Best, did you say?
Do you doubt me?
After what she said?
She said something to make you doubt our friendship? You must be mistaken.
My dear girl, I have eyes and ears. I can see and hear.
Well, tell me, what did Enid say?
She said she wishes you'd married one of the boys before they went to war.
Oh, that.
You admit it, and still you come here. That is what people say.
What do I admit? I don't follow your reasoning. I don't see what you're...
Of course you don't see. Love is always blind.
Love? We haven't said anything about love.
Of course not. It is a delicate word to use, and in this matter it is not, well, the world does not think it becoming.
Mrs. Packard, I do not understand your innuendos. Tell me the plain facts. What are people saying, and what has love got to do with it?
Mr. Haldeman.
Felix!
And you,
I?
They couple your names together.
They say that Felix and I, but it's a lie.
It makes no difference if it is a lie. The point is what people say.
But the people that say such things have rotten little minds and not enough brains to entertain themselves.
My dear Miss Chesborough.
And you repeat such slander.
You insinuate that
I do.
You have offended me.
No more than you have offended me.
Miss Chesborough, you will suffer for this. I tell you something in all friendliness of spirit to protect you from the slanders of the world, and then you reward me by...
You listen to idle tongues, and then you rob me of my happiness by putting poison into my mind.
I was telling you the truth, but people do not thank you for telling them the truth.
The truth? I am the one that knows the truth. I know that Enid and I are friends. And I know that Enid, Felix and I are friends, and that is all. Felix adores Enid. He would never care for another woman.
Oh, wouldn't he? Does the world know more than Mrs. Haldeman herself? It does not.
Why?
Just a few moments ago, in this very room, she told me herself that she wishes you had married because she knows that Felix is in love with you. She pretends to be your friend, but in her heart she hates you.
It's not true.
It is not pleasant to argue with you, Miss Chesborough. I shall find my hostess and make my excuses and not stay to dinner.
But if I have been too utterly rude, then I humbly apologise. But I cannot allow her to circulate such outrageous gossip.
Hello, Diana. When did you get here? Do you want to help me mix some cocktails? Rose, come can we have some ice? Well done.
Oh, Felix, a terrible thing has happened. They talk about us.
Who are they and who is us?
People. They talk about you and me.
Why, what have we done? Do you like a drop of orange bitter?
Oh, you're not taking this seriously.
Why, what is there?
Well, that's just it. What is there? I mean, if there really were something. Oh, it's most embarrassing. You're not making it easy for me.
My dear Diana, you can say anything to me.
Yes, but what if what they say is true?
Don't you know whether it's true or not?
Well, I thought I did, but after she said it, I began to wonder.
Wonder what? Come on, out with it.
You know I love Enid.
Well, you've grown up together.
And I wouldn't hurt her for the world.
No, you try.
And you do love her more than anything else, don't you?
Well, of course, but...
Don't say but.
But why?
Why did you say but?
Did I say but? I don't know. What was I saying?
But you said of course, but.
I don't know. You've got me so confused.
Do you think I'm in love with you?
Great Scott, do they say you're in love with me?
And you never have thought that?
Oh, Diane, I'm not so conceited to think that I...
Oh, good. But?
Now what, but?
Are you in love with me?
No!
Oh, thank goodness, but?
But what?
That's what they say.
That I'm in love with you.
And that I am in love with you.
And?
Exactly.
Holy smokes.
Oh, but it's not true.
No.
But they say it's true.
But what they say...
amounts to the same thing.
What can we do?
That's what I'm asking you.
Go straight to Enid.
Oh, but Enid believes it.
Nonsense.
No, she said so.
Which she said so?
Mrs. Packard, she said they all say it.
But how do they know?
Well, they don't, but they think they do. So it amounts to the same thing.
But Enid can't believe it.
But there's proof that she does believe it.
It's too absurd.
Mrs. Packard said that Enid had said that you had said that you were in love with me or something like that. And that Enid hates me.
Oh, no, that's not true. I know she likes
you. But Mrs. Packard wouldn't dare say anything.
Mrs. Packard said Enid hates you.
Oh, perhaps she does. Perhaps she is jealous of nothing at all. Perhaps she does hate me. Perhaps she's been imagining things that aren't true and saying things and making it seem as if...
Diana? Mrs. Packard tells me you insulted her and she feels she cannot stay for dinner.
I offered to apologise to Mrs. Packard, but she would not accept my apology.
Ah, so you do admit that you insulted me?
Only after you had insulted me.
You hear, Mrs. Haldeman? This is just as I said. She accused me of insulting her when I was trying only to be kind and give her little motherly advice.
Mrs. Packard chose to repeat some things that people are saying. Things that are manifestly untrue.
But whether they are true or not, it is highly unpleasant for me to have this altercation in my house.
Oh, I can tell by your voice that you're willing to listen to that woman.
Mrs. Haldeman, I resent being called that woman.
I don't care what you resent. You come in here and ruin a friendship I've had all my life. I don't care what I call you.
But my house, my guests.
Oh, don't worry. I won't stay a moment longer.
No, Diana, I can't let you leave in anger.
But I do. I leave with my heart flat against you for listening to that woman.
What did I say?
You said that Felix and I were in love with each other and you insinuated...
I never said such a thing in all my life.
Mrs. Packard, just a few moments ago in this very room...
I never said such a thing in all my life.
Can you look me straight in the eyes and tell me you never said it?
I never said it. Never, never, never.
But did you not tell me that you had eyes and ears and that you could see and hear and that people are saying...
But what everybody else says isn't what I say.
But you told me that Felix was in love with me.
I didn't know that. She told me that.
I didn't say that.
My dear, you did in this very room a few moments ago.
I didn't say any such thing, and how you can imagine...
I imagine nothing. I know what I see and what I hear, and you certainly told me that you ought to know all that I had heard
have no one to blame but yourself.
We have no one to blame but you.
Mrs. Packard, I didn't know I had to protect myself until you insinuated.
But, my dear, it was you yourself who told me that he wanted to marry her.
I said nothing of the sort. I said that he said...
I don't know what you're talking about.
Didn't you tell your wife that you wanted to marry Miss Chesborough?
I said no such thing in all my life. And whoever did got it out of nowhere.
He denies it, of course.
But he has to deny it. To admit it would be false.
Oh, whether it were true or false, he would have to deny it.
Why would he have to deny it?
Because the ethics of a gentleman would oblige him to deny it in order to protect you.
So it doesn't matter whether it is true or false. Nothing we can say or do can eradicate the thoughts from your mind.
Not my mind. Everybody else's mind. I have nothing to do with it.
Edith, can you not stand up and defend us?
Ah, you admit you must be defended.
The whole world needs to be defended against the women like you. If this were my house, I would show you the door. Enid, why don't you show her the door and prove that you trust Felix and I and that you know there isn't and never has been anything but just the most innocent of friendships between us? Oh, but you don't move. You don't trust me.
I have always trusted you. I never had the slightest suspicion. But perhaps I have been blind. Perhaps the world is able to see better from the distance and understand.
Enid, would you take the world's word against ours? Would you let a moment of silly gossip outweigh the love and loyalty that Diana and I have shown you for a lifetime?
Why don't you tell your wife that you love her?
I love my wife, but I see no reason to make a public statement of it. I stated that publicly the day I married her. She knows I love her, don't you?
Do I?
Oh, he adores you.
Don't you know it?
But Diana is pretty and...
Oh, Felix, I leave this house forever. Thanks to you, Mrs. Packard, I have lost two friends who meant more to me than ever the world's opinion. I shall never see either of you two again.
No, Diana, don't go. You cannot allow such contemptible gossip to stand between your friendship with Enid.
You see, he does not want her to go.
But it would never be the same between me and Enid again.
I do not want her to go, because I do not want an evil tongue such as yours triumphant. If you'd have come into our home and stolen our silver, you'd be no less a thief than you are now. New silver can be bought, but tarnished friendship can never be bright again. You caused this by your malicious remarks about my regard for Miss Chesborough.
I didn't say it.
Pardon me, you did.
I didn't say it. She did. I didn't.
You did. Oh, what does it matter how it's done? It's done. Our friendship is over. But I won't leave this place without leaving my memory here clean and white. I don't care what the world believes, but I want Enid to know that I've never had a thought against her. And so I'm going to tell her something, even though I'd rather have died than told her this before.
Ah, now we shall hear something.
Be careful, Diana. You're under no obligation.
So you know what she is going to say?
No, he doesn't know what I am going to say. No one does. It is my secret. There is only one man I love, or have ever loved. And he's over there.
She's making it up. A likely story.
I am not making it up. And if you don't believe me, then I shall have to tell you his name.
No, Diana, we don't demand that of you.
Oh, but the world will not believe me, and I want Enid to know the truth. It is Aubrey Lawrence.
Aubrey Lawrence? He wanted to marry you.
It's true, he did, but Diana wouldn't.
Why wouldn't you?
Because I did.
You married him?
Yes, the day before he left.
But your family didn't like him.
I know, that's why I didn't tell them. But you are free to tell them now, Mrs. Packard.
He hasn't any money.
No, but he's strict to the core. I'm awfully glad, Diana.
So am I, Diana. Forgive me.
to breathe to a soul.
Not to a soul.
Diana, I'll never forgive you for not telling me you married Aubrey. Why didn't you tell me you married Aubrey?
But I didn't.
You didn't?
But you said.
Oh, what I said. It doesn't matter what I said.
But she'll tell everyone.
Of course she will.
But if it's not true.
But I told him it wasn't.
But it's not, is it?
It might be.
Oh, but now I don't know whether to believe you or not.
And people won't know whether to believe her or not.
But Diana, when Aubrey hears about it, what will he think?
Oh, he will wish it were true.
But what will he say about you?
Oh, that I wish it were true.
And do you?
I do.
Have you found out since he left that you really love him?
Oh, madly, madly, madly.
Shall I send him a telegram, Sam?
I have already.
You haven't?
I have. I'm going to marry him the first day he gets home on leave.
Do have a cocktail on that.
Thank you, Felix.
Thank you, Felix. But when we tell people you married him, after Mrs. Packard has told him you are married already, what will people say?
What will people say? Exactly what they choose.
Bye.